I'm Sabrina. We're gonna be making cake pops at my house. It's super late. It's about 11 at night, and we are super pooped. We've had a long day, the both of us. This is my best friend Yvonne, and we're actually making cake pops for a party that I'm having tomorrow. This is a great dessert that you can make at home, super easy, and it's wonderful. Your guests will love it. And one thing I really like about it is they're this small, but it's just enough because they're so good. I'm making a red velvet cake with some blue candy topping to it. Anyways, I'm tired, so you'll have to excuse me if you don't understand what I'm saying. But basically, one thing I didn't do because I'm so tired is I didn't show you how to prepare this cake mix. And what you do is after you've baked your cake, you let it cool, very important, let it cool, then cut it, and then you're gonna just crumble it. Once it's crumbled and you put it in this pot here or a big pan, you're gonna add frosting to it. I put cream cheese in mine because I like cream cheese. I also put walnuts in my cake batter, which is gonna be so good. But that's what you pretty much do. So, and the reason why you put the frosting or whatever in it is to make them sticky and so they stick together. Once we're done preparing all of these balls, we are going to put them in the freezer to cool down just for a few minutes. And then we're gonna show you how to put the little sticks in and dip them. So I like to use Wilton candy melts. However, I find that a lot of people don't really like them because of the way that they melt. And I found that to be very true. If you follow the directions and put them in the microwave, they tend to be really lumpy. The consistency is not very easy to work with. So one thing that you can do is create a double boiler. And the way to do that is just by putting a pan, filling it up to there with water, not very much, maybe halfway. You don't want the water to touch the glass plate. So you just want the steam to actually melt the candy melts. If the water touches it, it will also create a lumpy texture, which you do not want. Otherwise, the cake balls will turn out to not be very smooth. So it's all melted. However, it's not as runny as I'd like it to be. It's still a little on the thick end. So one thing I will add that I've also learned after trial and error is I'm gonna add either vegetable oil or Crisco baking sticks, and that's pretty much it. You're just gonna get a little piece of it, not very much, and put it in, like about a teaspoon or a tablespoon, depending on how much chocolate you're using. Melted the candy melts on the double boiler. I like to put them in a ceramic cup. That way it can hold the heat for about 30 minutes, which is great if you're working with something like dipping chocolate balls, which can take a while. So these are great for that purpose, and I just want you to look at the texture of this candy melt, because this is how it should look. It shouldn't have any lumps in it. It should be very smooth, very creamy. That's definitely how you want it, and I believe the Crisco or the lard or shortening, whatever you want to call it, that really gives it that texture and consistency. So ceramic cups, great for not having to keep reheating the candy melts. These have been in the freezer for about 5 minutes. What you want to do is you want to dip your stick into the chocolate melt and then dip it in here. What that does is we're gonna allow this to dry just like this before we dip the entire ball in. So you're just gonna continue doing that with all of your balls. Take them out of here. What you wanna do is lightly tap them against your finger, just lightly, and all the excess chocolate melt will come off, just like that. And just kind of twist them, spin them as you're doing that. Making
cake pops. Stop.
11 o'clock at night and we're making
cake pops.
We're making cake pops. Cake pops. Hello, we are at my house and we making cake pop. Then let it cool, and once it's nice and cold, you're gonna cut it with a knife and frosting. If you're making chocolate cake, you could put chocolate frosting. Hey, look, you. Can you come a little close? What you wanna do with this? So, what you wanna do. My keys. No, leave Bella alone. So, what you wanna do is, this is pretty much how it's gonna look. My helper has left. Come on, Ania, show it. Let's see how we're gonna do the balls. Some warm water and. That's hot. Don't touch that. My helper's disappearing. So we're just gonna dip it in here. Wow. Oh my gosh. What the hell is that? Tully, this is not working.
Oh my god, I got Tully's butt in the thing.
Once you get them about there, you're gonna go ahead and decorate them. Be careful, not so much. Oh.